Hello and Happy New Year! I am Cassie Betker, Director of Youth Ministries here at Forest Hills Church, and I am so excited to bring you the first devotional of 2021. I hope you all had a wonderful New Year's Eve, and we can start this year off with hope we have in Christ. But before we go into that, let's go back to 2020 and go through our memory verse for this past week. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creation has come, the old has gone, and the new is here. 2 Corinthians 5:17. Now, I am not a winter person. The whole idea of cold and snow is just not for me. I like the idea of staying in with a hot cup of coffee and a good book or movie. But I work with teenagers, and they have a lot of energy to run off. So a few years ago, we took a group of our youth group over to Echo Bakken and went sledding with a couple of the other youth groups in our area. Now, even though this was a particularly warm day in January, by the end of it, there was a few of us that were a little cold and quite excited to go home and get into some warmer clothes and some hot food. When I started to think back on that past winter, I was reminded of a devotional that was posted on the Today in the Word website, and it was written by Chris Rapazzini. He starts in 2 Corinthians. Paul paints a picture of the glorious home that is waiting for all who believe, our heavenly dwelling. 14 years before Paul penned this letter, he was caught up with Christ in paradise. This is 2 Corinthians 12, 2-4. And in that text, you see he gives the Corinthians a glimpse of what he experienced in the midst of the present reality. We see this in 5:1-4. First, Paul acknowledges the suffering, the groaning, the brokenness that exists in our world. It kind of sounds familiar to what we're going through too. He doesn't deny it though. He doesn't overlook it or explain it away. Rather, he embraces the fallenness of humanity and recognizes that God has something so much better in store for us. This past year stretched and challenged us. It taught us a lot about ourselves, one another, and God. It also displayed, and perhaps more clearly than ever, the depravity of our world and the utter need for an ultimate healer, rescuer, and peacemaker. Our Lord Jesus Christ is all of those. It is not a guarantee that this year will be easier, but we can rest assured that He has made us for this very purpose. What awaits is something brand new, and He will be with us all the way home. The new year offers each of us a fresh start. Probably more than ever, you are longing for something new. Allow the Lord to show you which areas of your life need a new beginning and choose to begin each day in His Word. Whether you're watching our daily devotionals on Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays, continue to also do daily devotionals. Get into your scripture. Read what God has for us. It is through His Word that we are able to see the plan He has laid out for our lives. Let's pray. Father God, we are excited for what you have in store for us in 2021. Whether it's more trials and struggles or joyous celebrations, we know you are right there next to us. Lord, help us through this year to continue to stay grounded in your word. Help us in our spiritual practices of daily prayer and meditation. Lord, bring out those words of scripture to us that we need to hear on the day we need to hear it. Lord, keep our heart and mind focused on you. Jesus, we ask this all in your name. Amen. Until Sunday, January 3rd, keep calm and carry God.